everyone. I'm Dr. Zia, a clinical psychologist specializing in transgender care. Welcome to my channel. Today, I want to talk to you about social construction of gender and how it actually tends to inform our sense of identity, how it tends to actually feed and create or break apart internal sense of schema of who we are. And I'll explain that later. The reason why I want to talk to you today about a social construction of gender is because I noticed some of the people comment in a section below and asking me if gender is a social construct. Why then people need to go through transition? Why not just change your own idea or your own concepts, or in other words, your own construction of gender within your head? And the reality is that it's really not that simple. It's actually quite more complicated than that. And one tends to feed into each other, and one tends to inform another. And I want to explain to you how that tends to work. So let's first talk about what is a social construction. Social construction of really anything is pretty much a meaning or a notion that is assigned to an object or either an event that is created by majority of society. So a majority of people in society decide that a particular object or particular event are going to have particular meaning or set of meanings, and then people tend to ascribe those meanings to those objects or to those events. One of the things to keep in mind about social construct is that it's not set in stone. It's pretty much just a majority of cultural notions or cultural ideas. We have seen how social construction of so many things have been changing and evolving over the years. Gender especially. One can clearly see how gender has been evolving and how has been changed through society, through the culture, through generations. Just look at women, for example. There was a social constructed idea of women way back that women were should not work, women could not own property, women could not vote. You can see that social idea has changed. There was even a social constructed idea that women could only be there to bear children and to stay home and to be housewives. And the whole marketing scheme was surrounding around that. Same thing about men. There are always a social constructed idea going on about the idea of what we see and how we understand genders. And so you have to understand that it's just culturally informed to you, and in no way it is inaccurate. It's just pretty much majority of people deciding on a particular notion. But as we historically know, majority is not always right and is not always accurate. In this way, what we can see is that gender in of itself is not a static concept. It is not set in stone, but it is fluid. And as such, it's really up to each individual interpretation. But of course, the society also plays a role in it. And let me explain how. Before I explain how it plays a role, let me clarify the difference between biological sex and social construct of gender. The two tends to overlap, but people tend to really confuse and mesh them together. Biological sex is a biological attribute that people are born with based on their biology. So when a person is born, they're assigned either male or female based on their chromosomes, their genes, and their external genitalia. For people who don't tend to fall into what we see as male and female, sex assignment of intersex is assigned to them. That is a biological sex. Within the biological sex, there's many variations and many attributes that tend to overlap. What we socially have taken is that we have taken the concept of biological representation of a female, for example, and we label her with an idea that a female means a woman. And what it means to be a woman is all of the things that we see today in society. And that is a social construct. There are biological differences based on chromosomes between the sexes. We see that. That is undeniable. Nobody's trying to negate nor deny it. But what people are saying and what people are trying to explain as well is that apart from biological differences, there's all of these nuances about what makes us as individuals and how we express ourselves within those nuances, especially in relationship if gender. And it goes beyond those biological differences. So to take a concept of what it is to be a man or a woman and just layer it immediately to somebody who was assigned male or female at birth is incredibly reductionistic in my view, and really negates a lot of diversity and a lot of variations that people have in their representation, in their relationship to their gender, and most of all, their role and expression of gender. So let's be clear again, there's difference between biological sex, but how we layer the understanding socially, that's a socially constructed idea. So when people say, if gender is such a social construct, why do people then need to go through transition? Well, The thing is that when we're born into a culturally informed context. And that context does, one way or another, dictate and shapes up our inner formation, our inner schematic representation of how we see ourselves. Remember, I always talk about gender identity as being just a slice of a big pizza pie. Imagine that a big pizza is your whole holistic sense of self, and one pie is your gender expression, your gender representation, and maybe another slice is your career identity, and maybe another slice is some other form of piece of your identity puzzle. But that one piece of pizza thus gets to be informed by social cultural ideas of how we see gender. And in today's world, we still see gender through a very binary constructed idea. And so when you're born, there's also your genetic predisposition, there's also how the hormones and everything is affecting you, there's your body changing, there's puberty happening, there's your relationship to your body changes, and then there's also your understanding of who you are in terms of your gender, your understanding of who you are on innate, on a deeper sense, and then your understanding of what the world is now telling you about how and through which lens it sees you. And because the gender constructed view of gender in this world is incredibly narrow. As a result, if you are not in alignment with how the world sees you, you're experiencing incongruency. But that schema tends to form and solidify over the years, especially the context, especially for those of you watching who are older. You know this very well because your schema is very, very solid. This is why it's very difficult when you come out later in life. It's very difficult to go through transitions. Sometimes it can be very difficult because there's so much of that schema is kind of wrapped up in your pizza slice of identity of gender. Because that social schema is something that we can't run away of. We live in it, we saturated it. But majority of the world sees the construction of gender in a particular way, it's very hard to allow yourself to express yourself, to be much more fluid about your gender than what the world sees and dictates. Fortunately, today, younger generation, we see that much more with them, where they are living in a world where the construction of gender is starting to slowly change. And as a result, they have the vocabulary and they have an idea of something beyond just a binary, very socially imposed ideas of gender. But this gender social view tends to always form our schema. And the schema tends to either be something that we start to identify with, and some of us do, and that's how people feel congruent and comfortable with their gender, because those socially constructed ideas is also how they see themselves, how genuinely they see themselves. And some people become gender non-conforming and they modify some of those things. And then for the rest of you, that social constructed idea of gender is not something that is in alignment at all with who you are. And as a result, it's not just a matter of changing internal mental paradigm, because the reality is that you're still walking through the life, presenting particular way, and if the world is not fluid in terms of gender acceptance, it's going to be very hard to express yourself. It's going to be very hard to really be able to be in one with how you see yourself. And that's why it's not so easy. So when people say, well, gender is such a construct, or it's so easy, why don't you just change your constructed idea of who you are? No, that social culturally embedded context have modified and has created your internal schema. And changing that schema takes a while. Those of you who are older, who have transitioned, you know this because you have commented, and I've seen this in my clients as well, where even though you have transitioned and even though you have fully have feel like you integrated yourself, you still feel like you can't really break away from this mold that had been superimposed on you culturally and socially. And that's what I'm talking about. The socially constructed molds sometimes end up being a prison, end up being these walls into which we're put in, and to break from those walls can be very difficult. And even if we break through them, it almost becomes something that we're so, in a way, conditioned, so in a way, almost like a secondary learning, so that it's always in the back of our minds. And some of you know this and experience this. So the idea of social construction of gender and internal schema go hand in hand, as you can see. And it's not so easy as just changing how you think about gender. It's much more complex. And that's why people need to go through very strenuous medical and surgical transition in order to actually modify the external secondary characteristic in order to achieve that alignment. So that's what I want to talk to you today about this idea of social construction, because people often very much confuse that with biological sex and biological sex differences, which are not necessarily the same things. They do overlap, but they do not mean exactly the same. So hopefully this is helpful. Comment below. Let me know, what are your ideas of a social construct of gender? Especially if you're older, how have you seen the ideas of gender culturally starting to evolve and modify and change and shift? And comment below, let me know whether that has modified or changed your internal schema of how you see yourself. And I'll talk to you guys all next time. Bye.